Our first guest tonight is a three-time Grammy Award-winning singer and songwriter whose new single, Houdini, as well as the two-time Grammy-nominated song, Dance the Night, from Barbie the Album, are both available now. You can also see her in Argyle, which will be in theaters everywhere on February 2nd. Please welcome back to the show our friend, Dua Lipa, everybody! So wonderful.
Thank you very much.
You look so refreshed from the last time I saw you, and I see you have the shacket.
I have your shacket with me.
This is the shacket I was wearing when we went day drinking. I tried very hard to match my shacket to your hair.
You did a good job.
I have
to
say,
I think actually I'm much closer to the color now. I did it on purpose.
Oh, thank you.
I tried to coordinate.
The whole time we were drinking, you were looking at my shacket and you were like, that's it.
That's the color I
need. That's the color. Now, we did go day drinking. You were all in. I was all in. We were having a grand old time.
Yes.
And I should note that at sometimes during day drinking, we offer to the host, or the guest, I should say, do you want to switch to shots of water?
Yes.
You were a big no on that.
Yes, I understand. I've said yes a lot. Look, first of all, I'm just very happy that I get to live another day.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I don't know, not something that I like to brag about, but I think I'm a good drinker.
Yeah. You came into it with the confidence of somebody who'd maybe had a couple.
Well, I just wasn't prepared.
Yeah.
For what was waiting for me, because
yeah. It was.
Can I just tell what happened?
Yeah, I would love to hear.
You guys want to hear?
Yeah.
So within like 45 minutes, we were having a laugh. We were talking. We started drinking. It was multiple shots, lots of different types of shots: gin, vodka, rum, tequila.
All the ones you're not supposed.
All the
to
ones
do on
you're
the
not
same
supposed
day.
To mix at the same time. About 12 of those in like 45 minutes.
That's about right. Yeah.
And then we were like, all right, let's have some lunch. And I was like, oh, great, like some food, that'd be great. I was smoking cigarettes at the time. I've stopped, I've quit, guys. But I was like, all right, I'm just gonna have a cigarette, that will like sort me out. And you're like, no, I don't smoke. I was like, you do now.
Yeah. I'm glad to hear you quit, because after that day, I haven't been able to stop.
Okay, yeah. Great. After that, I started getting a little bit dizzy. I was like, I'm just going to pop to the bathroom. I'm sure I'm going to be completely fine. And I fall asleep.
Yeah.
Right there. And so... And I
should say, I went to the bathroom at that bar. It did not look like a luxury bedroom.
No. No, it wasn't a luxury bedroom. But for some reason, everything felt comfortable.
Yeah.
I was very cozy and whatever, I was just slumped.
Yeah.
And I thought I was going to be fine. I was like, don't worry, I'm going to be okay. Maybe I'll have a Red Bull. Nothing was working. So the only thing I remember after that point is the fact that I woke up in my bed and I just have this vision of my assistant who really, she saved my life. But all I heard was her telling my security, John, get the wheelchair. I was full ragdoll. I don't remember a thing. It was amazing. And I woke up like 2 hours later and I was like, what happened? What happened? And then I FaceTimed you.
Yeah, we FaceTimed. It was like not even 6 o'clock and we were both fully in bed. We had both passed out so hard. The funniest thing
is... I was in my clothes and everything.
Yeah, we were both fully clothed, it should be noted. We were, like, I think I still had my coat on. Funny thing to me is I was behind the bar and people kept coming up being like, Dua, it just needs 5 more minutes. I'm like, great. And then someone was like, she just needs 10 more minutes. I'm like, you bet, Dua's gonna be great. And then they were like, hey, she's gone. And I'm like, what? And they were like, that woman in the wheelchair? I'm like, I thought that was Dua Lipa? That's how drunk I was.
Oh, it's good.
It was really good.
Yeah.
But I am so happy you're okay. I never would have forgiven myself. Especially because it would have been I would have felt so wrong to have ended what had been such a wonderful and exciting year for you. And this year, as well, 2 Grammy nominations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Dance the Night. Yes. Not only a wonderful song, which is getting, you know, all this appreciation on its own, but part of a movie that was just a cultural phenomenon. Did you have any sense while you were making and participating in the Barbie movie that it was going to be this?
You never have any idea what's going to happen. Not when you make a song, or especially, like, for me, working on a film set was a new experience. But I think just the energy of everyone, whether we were in the studio, in the room, or on set, everyone was so excited. Everyone felt like they were part of something really special. And so I think that really also mirrored with the audience. I feel like Barbie really captured the cultural zeitgeist, and everyone got dressed up in pink and went to the cinema, and I think kind of brought that love back again for just going to the movies, which I think is really important. I think we're not doing it enough.
It also seems, I know you've won Grammys, you've been to Grammys, and you get to go again as a double nominee. That probably never gets boring either.
No, it never gets boring. You know, I love a dress up. I love going.
Do you know? I mean, I know you've got, less than a month. Do you know exactly where you're wearing it, or is that too soon for doing it?
Oh, yeah. I'm very well prepared. I'm, like, organized. I think it's just so fun.
Do you get nervous, or in a good way, do you still enjoy the night?
I get nervous, for sure. I think it's more like adrenaline and excitement that kind of amounts to the same. But, it's just exciting, and it's nice to be around my peers and just see different people that you don't really get to see as often. It's all fun.
You also released Houdini, which is a wonderful song.
And thank you.
We'll be part of a third album.
Yes.
It's on its way. You did something, and again, at this point, I would believe you're brave enough to do anything after the very brief amount of time that I spent with you. I mean, half of what we had planned to, but, you know, I don't want to get into that. I don't know if this was your idea or a BBC reporter's idea, but you decided once Houdini was done that you, the first person who was ever going to listen to it would just be a random person you found on the street.
Yes.
And you agreed to this, which is really quite bold because, especially based on who you selected, did not strike me as someone who would maybe be a Dua Lipa fan.
Yeah, I think that was kind of the point, is to try and pick someone who just probably would have no idea who I was and get a real opinion.
So I want to show a quick clip. This is Dua on the streets just selecting a unwitting person to be lucky enough to hear Houdini for the first time.
Do you know who this is?
No.
Do you know Dua Lipa?
I've heard of Dua Lipa.
You're about to hear her song for the first time in the whole world. You're going to be the first person to hear it. Would you like to?
Why not?
Let's do it.
Sorry. Okay.
Excellent. It would be impossible not to like it.
It's
enjoyable, bouncy, I dance along to that.
Very well done. Very nice review.
That was the review.
Really
that
good.
Was the review. He was so sweet.
He was genuinely very sweet.
Yeah, it was really nice.
Watching him dance to it. Undeniable. He basically was like, who could say this isn't a good song? Yeah. I dare anybody to say it. I should know one of the things we were going to do was recreate the Houdini video. That was something we planned to do.
I know. I was
so in the future, maybe you and I should try to do that.
Maybe we can have a couple drinks and see what happens.
See what happens, yeah. you also, tell me a little bit about Service 95, excuse me.
Service 95, yeah. So basically, I started Service 95 almost now 2 years ago. And it was really, what I call it is a cultural concierge. And I basically wanted to bring lots of different articles and stories and recommendations and lists from all around the world of different things that people might not go looking for, but to make it really accessible. Like, you could be in a different city somewhere in the world and you want to find out what the best galleries are or what to go and see and do. And it was really something that I love to do for my friends. They always message me to just get my lists. And so I was like, I'm just going to share it with everyone. And I also get to commission really interesting stories from around the world and kind of get different perspectives, and it just kind of, it comes to everybody's inbox for free every Thursday. So if you want to sign up, it's service95.com. And I just feel like they're really cool and interesting stories that people don't really go looking for. We actually have a really great issue coming up. It'll be our 100th issue.
Congratulations.
Next week.
That's a big number.
Yeah. And I wanted to interview lots of 100-year-olds.
Did you really?
Yeah, and wanted just to see, like, their way of life and what makes them happy and what they feel like is the key to, you know, living a really long life.
Did you get good insight from 100-year-olds?
Yeah, there was... Do you know what? I'm going to leave it for everyone to check it out.
Okay.
But it's it's just very wholesome and lovely, and we took wonderful pictures of them, and so those will be on our newsletter next week.
I was looking over your, you have a book club.
I have a book club.
Your favorite books of the year.
Yeah.
We have a book that we both love, Say Nothing.
Oh, Patrick Redden Keith.
It's an amazing book,
amazing
right?
Amazing book.
Yeah, I was glad to see it on your list. I feel like almost every, it's a wonderful, thrilling, true life mystery, IRA, it's everything about it
it's incredible. And you know, it's political writing, but what I love about it, it's written like it's fiction almost, because it just keeps you on the edge of your seat, and it's a history that maybe some people know about between England and Ireland, but it's just fascinating. He does it so brilliantly, and I'm a big fan. So,
Service 95, how did you come up with it? What's the 95 for?
So 95 is the year I was born, 1995.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't believe I drank you under the table. You're so much younger than me.
Whatever. I need to redeem myself, I think.
Well, you know what? We will allow you, maybe. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, let's do a couple of the things that we were gonna do that we ran out of time for when we were day drinking. You guys.
Let's do it.
Let's do it, Lipa. We'll be right back.